Hello, mga students. So allow me to discuss to you the budgeting process in the Philippines. And of course, this topic is under government accounting. Now, this is a summary discussion because this is intended to supplement only what's in the book. So the details will be on the will be part of the responsibility of the students, no? The studying of the details. Or the reading from the materials or from the book. Okay? Now, when we are talking of government accounting, this is budgetary accounting. And of course, no, where does it start? Saan ba ito nag-umpisa? Where do it begin? Ano, tama ba yung aking ano, grammar? Where does? Okay. What you will see here is the four basic, basic ba? The four phases of the budget cycle. Okay, it starts from the budget preparation and then followed by the budget legislation and then the budget execution and ultimately the budget accountability. And of course, no, saan po ito nag-umpisa? Nag-umpisa ito sa preparation ng ating national budget. Okay? So, umpisahan muna natin dito class sa budget preparation. Ano? In the Philippines, we call this a bottom-up approach. Pag sinabi po natin na bottom-up, nag-uumpisa from the bottom, paakyat sa top, no? And this is the opposite of the top-down approach. Kasi po, ano, in the process of preparing the budgets, ano, allow me to read from the book. Under bottom-up budgeting, several parties participate in the budget preparation. Actually, this is also being done. This is not a new idea. Kasi even in the private sector, ginagawa din po talaga itong bottom-up approach. Hindi bottom-up, ha? Kasi baka nagiinuman tayo dyan. Okay, pag bottom-up approach, no, may participation la ang mga bawat departments. They deliver their budgets for their respective divisions. So here, in our case, in the government accounting, each local government, lahat ng mga government sector, basta ikaw po ay part ng government at kinakailangan ng budget, syempre, ano, you take part, you participate. Okay? So this is what we call the bottom-up approach. Now, under budget preparation, meron po tayong tatlong kinakailangang bantayan dyan or tandaan. The budget call, the budget hearing, and the presentation to the Office of the President. Okay? Tignan po ninyo ito. Pinick up ko lang itong ating visual from the other video lecture. Tinanggal ko muna si COA here on the top and then si Bureau of Treasury here on the bottom. So, niretain natin si Department of Budget and Management and then the government agencies. Pag sinabi po natin na budget call, ano, it starts from the Department of Budget and Management or the DBM. Okay? Kasi po, ano, under this budget call, syempre, the DBM will ask the government agencies, okay, let us deliberate. Pag-usapan po natin ang mga kanya-kanyang budgets po ninyo for your division, for your agency, ano, sa lahat ng mga ahensya ng gobyerno. So, budget call. Calls, this is a call for the budgets. Okay? So, the budget call contains, basahin ko lang because this is not included in my material, in what you are seeing now, no? It contains among others daw, okay, the next fiscal year's targets, the agency's budget ceiling, and other guidelines in the completion and submission of agency budget proposals. Okay? So, ayan po ano nakapaloob dito sa budget call. Now, once na nakapag-comply na ang mga ahensya ng gobyerno, ibabalik po nila ito sa Department of Budget and Management for the budget hearings. No? Dito, kumbaga, i-deliberate nila. Ito yung mga budget namin. Okay? So, they are defending their budgets. Sabi ni DBM, o, bigay ninyo or ready, prepare ninyo yung mga budgets ninyo. Pag okay na, ibigay ninyo sa amin. Now, once okay na, Diba? Bibigay na ito kay DBM o siyempre depensahan, no? We need to support, we need to defend. Bakit ganito yung mga figures? Kasi hindi naman pwede na basta-basta na lang yung budgeting, no? Kaya nga pag sinasabi natin class na budgeting, pinagpaplanuhan ito, hindi naman ito yung basta-basta na lang kung ano-ano yung mga pinaglalagay natin na figures. Okay? So parang ano lang yan sa mga eskwela, no? Pag nag-quiz, oh, the budget call is, okay, may quiz tayo. Yung budget hearing is that, okay, parang yung result ng quiz, ano? Okay, walang lawan, bagsak. Okay, hindi kasi nakapag-aral. Kaya kinakailangan, ano, may plan, pinagpaplanuhan, mayroong preparation. Basahin ko lang din from the book. Okay, para magkaroon ito ng konting laman, even though this is more of a summary. Budget hearings daw are conducted after the agency submit the proposals, no? The budget proposals. Each agency defends its budget proposal before the DBM. So, yung ano no, budget na pinapasa ng mga ahensya ng gobyerno, although hindi ko pala dito na ilagay, budget proposal. So, proposal pa lamang po ito, no? And then they will deliberate it with the DBM. Ito yung budget hearing. Okay? Of course, no? Siyempre, dahil nag-defend sila, so parang research proposal, ano? Thesis defense. Siyempre, kung yung DBM is the panel, anong ginagawa ng panel? Meron tayo, siyempre, no? Recommendations. Okay? Para kung sakaling may comment yung DBM on the budget o may mga inquiry, it has to be adjusted, it has to be updated. Okay? So, that is the process of the budget call and then the budget hearing. Now, once okay na po yan, okay, i-consolidate ni DBM. Ipapasa niya yan sa Office of the President. Okay? At ito po, ano, syempre, this is a consolidated na proposals from different government agencies. At nakapalagay po ito sa tinatawag natin na National Expenditure Program or NEP. Okay? And Budget of Expenditures and Sources of Financing. All those terms, no, hindi ko naman po i-emphasize ng lubusan dito because that will be your responsibility to read from your materials or from the book. Okay? Again, this is more of an overview rather than a detailed discussion. Okay, for my actual students, no, this may have already been discussed through the students' reports. Okay? Ayan. Now, ibibigay po ito sa Office of the President. And of course, no, together with the cabinet members, sisilipin nila itong proposal, itong budget proposal na consolidated lang lahat ng mga ahensya ng gobyerno. Kapag umokay na po yan at na-aprubahan na po itong proposed budget, okay? Ang tawag na natin dyan ay yung President's Budget. Okay? We call it now the President's Budget. This is the approved budget proposal. Pero hindi pa po yan ano, yung katapusan. Hindi po yan yung ating national budget. Pero ano pa lang, inaprubahan pa lang yung proposal. Pero may pagdadaanan pa po ito. Okay? Dadaan po. Siyempre, ibabalik po ito sa DBM para i-update, no? And then, once na-finalize na yung mga budget documents, ipapasa na po ito sa Congress. Okay? Itong budget proposal or itong approved budget, no? By the by the President, by the Office of the President. Approved proposal, no? For deliberation naman ng Congress. Kasi kailangan po itong i-enact, no? May legislative, ano pa tayo, process. Okay? Now, from the Congress, okay, dito na tayo papasok sa pangalawa, the budget legislation. So kanina, nandito pa lamang po tayo sa budget preparation. Kaya nga, ulitin ko lang ha, the President's budget is not yet the final budget, yung tinatawag natin na national budget. Hindi pa po. Yan pa lamang po yung ipapasa sa Kongreso para i-deliberate, para silipin, no? I-update, i-revise bago po natin ito isabatas. Ito yung naririnig po ninyo na General Appropriations Act. Okay, now, tignan po ninyo ito. meron tayong tinatawag na House deliberations. Meron tayong Senate deliberations. The House deliberations ay yung nasa lower house. This is the Congress. The upper house, this is the Senate. Okay, House of Congress, and then yung House of Senate. Okay, now, yung ating tawag nito, the president's budget will be deliberated first in the Congress, no? Dito, House deliberations. Okay? Now, ito pong deliberation na ito, ano, syempre, this will dapat mabusisi. Imagine, ano, ito yung mga trabaho ng mga kongresista. Okay? At pagkadami-dami nila, no? I don't have first-hand experience or exposure to this because hindi naman po ako nagtrabaho sa gobyerno on the audit side, no? Currently, nagtatrabaho ako sa gobyerno pero bilang part-time accounting instructor, ano? Pero that is a different field, no? Teaching versus etong mga accounting and budgeting process. Now, dito po ano, pag umokay na at na, well, usually kaya nga kinakailangan dito. Sa alam niyo naman politics, no? Dapat kakampi ng pangulo ang karamihan ng mga nasa house para maaprubahan yung budget. Otherwise, nabubusisihin itong mabuti kung ang majority ng nasa house ay the opposition. Okay? Kaya nga this is a political matter eh, yung preparation ng mga budgets. Okay. Now, once the president's budget is approved on the lower house, on the Congress, no, sa mga representatives, tawag na po natin dyan ay General Appropriations Bill. Okay? GAB or GAB. Okay? Bill pa lamang po ito, House Bill. It will be then be deliberated by the Senate. Okay? So, meron pong separate na deliberation from the senators, ano? Although, nag-uumpisa ito after na maaprubahan ito ng house, no? Ng lower house. Pero usually, for convenience, for expediency, ano, para mas mapabilis, while the house is starting to deliberate, while the Congress, no, the representatives are starting to deliberate the budget, nag-uumpisa na rin po yan si Senate. Okay, para kung sakali man may mga minor or kung ano man, major or minor changes man yan, at least no, hindi na sila mag-start from the start to save time. Okay? Now, kung may conflict po ano, kung hindi sila mag-agree dito, kailangan na ma-ratify. Kailangan magkaroon sila ng agreement dito ano in a one budget. Kaya nagkakaroon tayo ng tinatawag na bicameral deliberations. Okay, meron tayong tinatawag na bicameral conference committee. Okay, yung house, lower house and the upper house, no? Will agree on the approved ano no, budget, and this is coming from the bicameral deliberations. Kaya po ano, may araw tayo from the house, may araw tayo from the Senate. Okay, bago po ito ipasa at ibigay sa presidente. Now, once the ano no, the tawag nito, once the harmonized, ang tawag kasi natin dito is harmonized general appropriations bill. Kapag na-agree na on both ano no, houses, on the Congress and then the Senate, no, kapag okay na po 'yon, ipapasa na po ito or i-forward na po ito sa president para i-approve or i-veto kung sakaling disagree yung pangulo. Okay? Now, once the president enacts, kaya natin nilagay dito ano, enactment, president's enactment. Kapag in-enact na po ito ano, ang tawag na natin diyan is your General Appropriations Act. Na isa batas na. Naaprubahan, napirmahan na ng pangulo yung batas na 'yon. Yung isinamiting ano, Harmonized General Appropriations Bill. Okay? So medyo may kahabaan po ito. I'm just not sure if how long ito usually ano no, tumatagal sa Congress para mag-approve ng isang ano no, maaprubahan yung national budget. Okay? So, eto na, approve na po yung ating national budget. Ayan. So, that is your budget legislation. Now, Dako tayo dito sa budget execution. For the budget execution, ito naman po yung mga kailangan ninyong tanda na nasa kanan, no? Release guidelines and budget executions, allotment, incurrence of obligations, and disbursement authority. Ito lalong-lalo na babalik at babalikan po natin ito kasi, no, more of budget accountability tayo dito, ano, sa government accounting. So in terms of the disbursements, even the receipts, ano, of billings, collections, mga natatanggap na pera ng gobyerno. Okay? So this will be coming from this phase, ano, of our budgeting. Now, ano po ba dito sa release guidelines and budget execution? Ito na naman tayo, no? The Department of Budget and Management will provide the government agencies with the guidelines, ano, sa pag-re-release ng ano nila, portion, kung magkano man yung na-allocate na budget for their government, for those government agencies. Okay? Basahin ko lang at ilagay ko lang, no, sabihin ko lang ano yung nilalaman nitong mga release guidelines and budget execution documents. Okay? The DBM, the Department of Budget and Management, or the DBM, issues guidelines on the release and utilization of funds, while the various agencies submit their, ayan, budget execution documents. The DBM provides the guidelines, the government agencies provides the budget execution documents, or BEDs. Okay? Etong budget execution documents, no, it summarizes an agency's fiscal year plans. Nakalagay dito, ano yung plano nitong mga ahensya ng gobyerno ito for the fiscal year and performance targets. So ano yung kanilang ano, no, plinano, yung mga plans nila diyan for the year. Nakapaloob dito ang mga sumusunod: physical and financial plan, monthly cash programs, estimate of monthly income, and list of obligations that are not yet due and demandable. Okay? Class, this will be provided, ano, for this will be provided by every government agencies. It has to be given to the Department of Budget and Management. Okay? But the major recipients of the national budget are usually yung national government agencies, the local government units or LGUs, and of course, no, yung ating mga government-owned and controlled corporations. Okay? Now, in terms of how do they differ from each other, no, it will not be discussed in this video lecture, but it's more of your obligation naman para basahin ito or i-research on your own. Okay? Kasi once again, this should only be a summary discussion. Okay? Now, what's next? O, edi yung allotment, no? What is the allotment, no? Pag sinabi kasi class natin na allotment, this is an authorization issued by the Department of Budget and Management to government agencies. Kaya po yung arrow ay papunta sa government agencies. Authorization na nanggagaling sa DBM, ano, para mag-incur ng obligations. Please take note, no, before you can incur obligation, there should be an authorization first in the form of an allotment. You cannot incur obligation without the allotment. Please take that, no, into consideration. Please remember that. Okay? So, ang sinasabi po kasi, ano, na illegal daw po para sa isang government entity or for a government agency na mag-incur ng mga obligation without having first secured or received their allotment. Okay? Pag sinabi po kasi natin na incurrence of obligation or obligation, class, this is different from the, ano, no, obligation in the context of financial accounting. Kasi pag sinabi po kasi natin dito na obligation, ano, meron po yung ibang meaning. Okay? Allow me to just, ano, no, pick that up from our book. Pag sinabi po kasi natin na na obligation for the government entity, it is an act of duly authorized official which binds the government, okay, to the immediate or eventual payment of a sum of money. And obligation may be referred to as a commitment that encompasses possible future liabilities. So possible future liabilities may also be considered as an obligation for government accounting. Okay, samantalang for financial reporting, okay, yung obligation is usually ito yung synonymous with the term liability. And tandaan po natin, pag liability, present obligation arising from past events. Pero dito, for government entity, pag sinabi po natin na obligation, this may include possible future liabilities. Kahit hindi pa po nangyayari at hindi po natin siya pwedeng i-recognize for accounting purposes. Okay? So, please take note of that one. Now, so that's allotment and tawag nito, incurrence of obligation. Now, only after that, no? Only after the allotment can the government agencies incur obligation. And then the next step is the disbursement authority. And the disbursement authority naman is needed before the government entity or the government agency can access government funds. Ang allotment, kailangan natin para makapag-incur ng obligation. Okay? Ang disbursement authority, kinakailangan natin para makapag-access or makapag-release ng funds, okay, ng pondo. Without the disbursement authority, we cannot access the government funds. Hindi po tayo makakakuha ng pera. Okay? Now, basahin ko lamang po ito para naman for ano no, additional for counting details, no? The Department of Budget and Management issues this disbursement authority to the government agencies, and it is at this point where government agencies can obtain access to the government funds. Okay, dito po ma-encounter ninyo, and as we go along, no, yung mga tinatawag natin na NCA or the Notice of Cash Allocations. Okay, the NTA or the Notice of Transfer Allocation. Okay, may mga iba pang terms kayo na may encounter dyan like non-cash availment authority and cash disbursement ceiling. Okay, but the details will not be discussed here. Okay, now, meron po tayong tinatawag na modified disbursement system. Okay, just like impressed system, no, sa accounting for petty cash fund. And then for sa, ano, no, sa cash, control over cash, di ba, in-issue natin. Pag may payments tayo through checks, issuance, ganun din po ito sa atin sa gobyerno. Disbursements are most commonly made through checks that are chargeable against the account of the Treasurer of the Philippines. Yun nga lang, ano, ang check po natin, okay, pag nag-i-issue, okay, nakasaan ito? It is charged against the Treasurer of the Philippines. This is a single treasury account. Okay? Ang tawag natin dyan sa check-in na yan ay MDS check or Modified Disbursement System check. Okay? Now, after your budget execution, we have the budget accountability. At ito naman po yung tatandaan ninyo under the budget accountability. The budget accountability reports, the performance reviews, and then the audit. Tignan po ninyo ito. And normally class, no, the budget accountability is being done concurrent with budget execution. As we execute our budget, no, dapat accountable na po yung mga government agencies. Okay? And this is more of a monitoring din kasi. Okay? As the budget is being executed, it is regularly monitored to determine the conformance of actual results with planned targets. Kasi kahit naman sa accounting for private companies, no, for business entities, nagko-compare tayo ng budget versus actual. Kapag naka-prepare na tayo ng budget, usually yung annual budget, hinahati-hati natin ito into ano no, quarterly budgets and monthly budgets. para na-check natin on a monthly basis and then eventually in a quarterly basis, are we within our budget or not? Kasi doon sa mga cost centers, yung hindi kumikita, no, departments na hindi kumikita, dapat hindi tayo lumalagpas doon sa ating mga budgets. Okay? Doon naman sa mga revenue generating na mga yung mga profit center natin, okay, dapat naabot natin yung ating budgets, no? Kaya nga sa BIR may target sila na dapat ito yung makolekta natin for the year. Quarterly, monthly, meron silang mga ano diyan, ano? Threshold. Meron silang targets, no? Para ma-achieve natin yung target natin at dahil marami kasi si halimbawa si BIR siya yung pinaka main ano no? Revenue generating government agency. The majority of our governments are cost centers. Okay, class? Here kasi sa government accounting, important yung tinatawag natin na responsibility accounting. Okay? Kasi they have to consider ano dito yung mga controllable and non-controllable costs. Of course, no, you have already encountered responsibility accounting in your strategic cost management or equivalent subject. Okay? So, yung concept nun, hindi na po bago sa inyo. Ina-apply po natin ito sa government accounting. Okay? So, remember that budget accountability is being done concurrent with budget execution as a control, no? Pang-monitor, are we within our targets, no? Actual versus budget. Now, for the performance review naman, kasi itong ahensya ng gobyerno ay nagpapasa ng mga various reports kay DBM and even kay COA. Okay? And then, separately, individually, ano, si DBM at saka si COA ay nagpe-perform ng mga performance reviews. At pinapasa po nila ito sa Office of the President. Pangulo, ito po yung aming performance reviews of the various government agencies. Ito po yung aming na-observe, ganito, ganyan. Okay? Now, of course, no, si COA. Alam naman po natin na si COA yung taga-audit. So, COA performs the audits. Okay? Now, the budget reports, together with other budget records, provide information in preparing. Yung isa po natin at unique na financial statements dito sa ating ano, no? Government accounting, yung statement of comparison of budget and actual amounts. Kasi kasama po yan sa complete set of financial statements in a government entity. Okay? So, yun po ano. Hanggang dito lamang po yung ating video discussion, itong video lecture na ito. Sana, ano no, ay you take the opportunity to read from the book. I highly encourage you to read from the book. Or if not, you have to seek other material so that you can understand better what is the budgeting process all about. Especially in terms of the details, those that I have not covered here in my summary lecture. Okay? So hanggang dito lamang po yung ating discussion. Maraming salamat. Let me know if you have any questions. Bye-bye!